From this distant vantage point, the Earth might not seem of any particular interest, but for us, it's different. Look again at that dot. That's here. That's home. That's us. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives. The aggregate of our joy and suffering, thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines. Every hunter and forager, every hero and coward, every creator and destroyer of civilizations, every king and peasant, every young couple in love, every mother and father, hopeful child, inventor and explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there, on a mote of dust, suspended in a sunbeam. I'm killing myself this time, I have abused. I'm killing myself today, and there ain't nothing I can lose. I'm killing myself, well I'm lost, and I'm amused. I'm killing myself today, and there ain't nothing you can do. Nothing you can do!
Drift in my state, one of the way can I choose? Ooh. You're gone.
See that star? You mean that bright red one? His daughter asks in return. Yes, it might not be there anymore. It might be gone by now, exploded or something. Its light is still crossing space, just reaching our eyes now. But we don't see it as it is, we see it as it was. Many people experience a stirring sense of wonder when they first confront this simple truth. Why? Why should it be so compelling? The immense distances to the stars and the galaxies mean we can see everything in the past. Some as they were before, the Earth came to be. Telescopes are time machines. Long ago, when an early galaxy began to pull light out into the surrounding darkness, no witness could have known that billions of years later, some remote clumps of rock and metal and ice and organic molecules would fall together to form a place that we call Earth. And surely nobody could have imagined that life would arise and thinking beings evolve who would one day capture a fraction of that light and would try to puzzle out what sent it on its way. We can recognize here a shortcoming, in some circumstances serious, in our ability to understand the world. Characteristically, willy-nilly, we seem compelled to project our nature onto nature. Man, in his arrogance, thinks himself a great work worthy of the interposition of a deity. We long to be here for a purpose, even though despite much self-deception, none is evident. The significance of our lives and our fragile planet is then determined by our own wisdom and courage.